Okie dokie, everyone. We're back with more of LEGO Marvel's Avengers. This is Mega Man NG, and last time we've completed Lack of Insight. Now it's time we move on to the storyline involving Iron Man 3, the third and final Iron Man film in the trilogy. Ready? Aim. Fire! And yes, this one's gonna be quite a doozy.
You'd think that Tony Stark would be happy that he helped save the world from the Chitauri, but something about him's different now. He spends most of his time building new Iron Man suits at his mansion and has somehow managed to get himself in trouble with this mysterious menace known as the Mandarin. I'd like to think he knows what he's doing, but, well, he's Tony.
What do you expect? He's a billionaire playboy philanthropist with a suit of armor.
You see that lovely Malibu penthouse? Well, that's where I live with Tony Stark. Normally, it has a beautiful vista of the Pacific, but today, it has a fleet of gunships hired by the Mandarin to redecorate our lounge. He's the same villain that's been creating all kinds of chaos around town, even putting our friend Happy in the hospital. Guess he's not so happy now. Definitely not Tony's best decision, giving our home address to a bunch of lava-blooded villains. On a positive note, at least his new Iron Man suit fits me snugly.
Get her, I'm gonna find a way around.
Tony! You're okay, right? We need to get you out of here right now. See, this is why I don't like it when you bring your work home with you.
Well, what do you expect? And sad to say, this is only going to make things troubling. Yeah, so basically we're now reliving scenes from Iron Man 3, as I've already mentioned before. And Pepper's not that pretty good with the Iron Man armor. Not good at all. Yeah, we see it all right. And Pepper's also kind of clumsy. So what am I supposed to do? We need to get rid of all the fire. And Stark can't really do much. This is bad. Almost as bad as having the Mandarin buddies decide to wreck the place. Wreck the place, destroy everything. You name it, it's ridiculous. And they even have the gall to wreck the Christmas tree. You serious? So now what? Oh yeah, we gotta blast that. Yeah. Oh yeah, we gotta fix this first. Yeah, been quiet most of the playthrough so far because, yes, I'm just focused on getting the work done. Besides, after this one will be the last episode of the playthrough. I don't know if I plan on doing free play mode, but I got something else planned to make up for the fact that Mighty Number 9 got delayed. Let's only hope and pray that suit makes it out of there unharmed. Okay, we got that part done.
This isn't the time for gifts, Tony. How is that gonna help us?
Who knows, Pepper?
Oh, it's a robot. I probably should have guessed. Can you control it from your side?
Yes, we can. Man, we gotta hurry. Excellent. Now we can use it to clean things up. Aw, that's a bummer. Now we gotta blast this. Oh wait, missile. Gotcha! And now we're Iron Man, the way it's meant to be. Ah! Great, that's a bummer. Nice, he can't blast him, which stinks! Okay, so now we gotta solve this puzzle. Oh yeah, we got one, we got two, three, four. Much better. Well, at least that got blasted. Ah! One-hit kill, I forgot. Those helicopters are one-hit kill. Now. Yeah. Nice. Oh yeah, it's supposed to be on the other end. Now, can we, like, pray we can get the heck out of here? Oh, I see. Shoot this. Shoot this. Trying to get a good shot is not easy. And then we shoot this. Good. That takes care of the tree, but now we can start building this. Alright, we did it. And it just leaves us with all these parts. Do your thing, Stark! A what? Oh yeah, you gotta press the circle button rapidly for it.
Here's a little holiday greeting I've been wanting to send to the Mandarin.
Thank you, and a goodbye and good riddance. Fine, I'll just have to break them apart and then... Wait, everything's gathering around. And there you have it. Our way out.
Is that thing? All right, I get it. Let's just hope it works. More of these guys? Hope you've still got some tricks up that iron sleeve of yours, Tony.
We have plenty of tricks, Pepper. Now all we gotta do is shoot him down. Five choppers. Faster, that's one. That's two. That's three. Just one more to go, and that should do it. That's four. And there you have it.
For a second, we thought it was over, but a final missile slipped past. I watched in horror as the entire condo sunk into the abyss. Thankfully, Jarvis had managed to help Tony escape a watery end, but the suit had shorted out, leaving him stranded in Tennessee. Further adding to his troubles, the hot-headed villains happened to be visiting the area, and Tony's only ally was Harley, a local boy with a pretty mean potato gun. The pair were left with no choice but to take on the Flameheads together. Tony really should start keeping the rest of the Avengers on speed dial.
Whoa, that was so cool! I mean, you know, in a bad way. Shouldn't be too much of a problem. There are transformers around here that'll shut the power off. I accidentally did that. Twice.
Let's only hope they're enough. because we're now dealing with extremist enhanced beings. And they shoot fire blasts of all things. And we also have Harley, who's packed with a potato gun. Hey, I'm okay with it. Right around here. Now let's hack it. Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4. And the potato gun just works exactly like a regular pistol. Oh, you have got to be joking. Good. Now let's get to work building and repairing. Just like in the Iron Man 3 movie, his suit's short-circuited and now he has to rely on the help of a kid. Harley, of course. Come on. Why isn't it working? Oh, okay. That's Harley's work. All right, Stark. Let's see if this works. So,
all right. That's one of them taken care of. Now to find the other one.
Yeah, and the other one's probably on the other side. Yo, Harley, let's move it. Harley Keener's his name. Huh. Oh, come on. More of these guys? Please. Gotta beat up everything around. Harley? Engage. And they're even doing it inside? Come on, dudes. Stark, get in there and do some repair work. And I like how it's really clever they paint us like the Lego store. Lego stores are real. No problemo.
Hey, look, there's a transformer up here. Let's smash it and go.
At least with that, now we can progress further. And we just start beating stuff up, breaking everything down around us. Well, we got almost everything. Well, yeah. Just gotta shoot that thing down. Great, Stark's in trouble. Oh, he's in trouble. Hey, moron, newsflash, back off. Why do you have to pick on a kid? Seriously. That's not fun. Now we gotta deal with them and... Oh. Back away. Great. Extremis enhanced. That's the worst. And they still keep on coming. What gives? Whatever, they're gonna get a butt kicking, at least from me. And they're now taking the fight inside. We gotta follow.
looks angry. Like, really angry. How is she even glowing like that?
And it's spewing around a massive flame barrier. So, how are we gonna do this?
You got a plan for this, right? It kind of feels like we're a little outmatched right now.
You'll see.
And she's also gonna start throwing stuff at us. That's terrific. I wonder if this is gonna make it a little bit easier. Who knows? Yeah. Alright. Now let's get serious. Special delivery!
After some creative use of a microwave, Tony defeated the remaining extremis-fueled agents and headed off to take down the Mandarin. Then, things got complicated very quickly. The Mandarin turned out to be a washed-up British actor called Trevor, and the real villain was actually someone familiar. Not an ex-neighbor, but a nerd-turned-superhuman called Aldrich Killian. I've got to admit, he was looking much more suave these days. Killian only went and took me hostage, exposing me to extremis. He also kidnapped the president, too, and planned to serve him up like a roast turkey. Tony turned up to save the day, this time with Iron Patriot by his side and his entire back catalog of Iron Man suits. The 10-year-old with the potato gun would have come, too, but he had to tidy his room.
Yeah, we're now reaching the point in the film where Iron Man summons his entire legion of Iron Man suits against the extremist enemies. And that, to me, was one of the best parts of the film, without a doubt. Especially when Stark struggles and tries his hardest to, like, blast away, making sure the extremist guys go down. It's an all-out war. He even brought out some, like, Goliath-based bots. That was cool. And yeah, War Machine is also in the Iron Patriot suit. Originally, the Iron Patriot suit belonged to one Norman Osborn. However, in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, it's in the hands of James Rupert Rhodes. Well, nothing new here, so let's press onwards. Yep, that's one of the Iron Man armors. Thanks, Mike. You've been helpful. And that's it for Thor. And I'm just blasting away just so I can get True Avenger in this mission. Override. Excellent. Nice, we at least got one of the pieces. Last missiles. Only about a few hundred more left, and we may get True Avenger here. Oh dear. Oh, this isn't gonna end well. Stark, that's your cue! Sorry. Yeah, it gets worse. Gotta find a way out. Oh, wait, let's see. Nope, no missiles here. So now what do we do? Oh, we're gonna have to go around, huh? Alright then. Come on, I almost got this. Shouldn't take me this long. Yeah, we get how that works. Alright, Stark, you better do your thing, and quick! Excellent. Now to blast them with two missiles, and we have extremist morons behind us. Listen, if you're gonna be wasting our time, don't. Just don't, seriously. Excellent. Nice, we even got True Avenger, that makes it better. Look, if you're gonna try to get... Hang on, let's just beat them up first, and then press onwards. Now then, where were we? Back up top. This should at least help us reach to the top, and quick. Oh, great. Alright, now this will help. Figures they'd be bringing this along. Oh, that's for War Machine, huh? And this up here, blasting the sign. And hopefully this should fill up the rest. And wouldn't you guessed it, it does! Nice work, Rhodes. All right, now to take care of the extremis, dude.
You wanted the Mandarin, Tony? Well, here I am. I am the Mandarin.
And truth of the matter is, he was rather underwhelming as a villain. Very underwhelming. I'm not saying that Iron Man 3 was bad, don't get me wrong, it was pretty fun. Problem was that the villain was just a letdown. Especially when you learn at the end about who the real Mandarin was. And sadly, that's basically how it is. Alright, Aldrich, you want a piece? Let's dance. What goes up must come down, you get blasted for it. No, but we can always try and beat you no matter what you do. And I can't do anything but get up there. That stinks. Ah, great. I got incinerated. Yeah, you gotta stay far away. Now what's it doing? If you're trying to blast us, it's not gonna work. Yeah, now we force you down here so we can kick your butt. Let's do this. This guy's really determined to stop us.
I'm not afraid of you. I know you're a coward.
Well, he is a coward by the looks of it. Sorry, Rhodes. And maybe this time we can kick your butt the right way. Looks like we're not finished yet. Wait, I forgot, that's Stark's job. But Stark doesn't have his armor. Oh wait, he can fix things. He can more than make up for that. Now let's finish things up and end it in epic fashion.
You see? That suit was just like you! A failure!
Jarvis, do me a favor and blow Mark 42.
No!
Even after being cooked in an Iron Man suit, Killian was still up for another round. Luckily for Tony, I was in no mood for any more nonsense. Combining my terrifically toasty powers and an Iron Man repulsor, I flame-grilled the big geek. With that maniac out of the way, Tony celebrated by blowing up all his suits, promising to spend the holidays with me rather than with a screwdriver and an arc reactor. With the president now safe and sound, Tony promised to use his super genius to find a cure for the extremis enhancements, straight after we'd had a festive dinner. Oh, and after he'd had his shrapnel removed. Oh, and don't forget, he is Iron Man.
Indeed he is, and we own the trophy. Ready, aim, fire. That was a pretty fun level. And we also obtained True Avenger, so that's a plus for us. Indeed, we unlock Harley Keener, little kid, and the Iron Man Mark 42. And also the Iron Patriot. And Pepper Potts in the Mark 42. She's a bit clumsy. And we couldn't find Stan Lee, sad to say, but don't worry, we will find him eventually. And yeah, that's about it for this episode. We have one more episode left, and that's gonna be it. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to hit the like button. It really does mean a lot to me. And I'll see you guys next time when we do the last mission. And that's going to be it. This is Mega Man NG, signing off. Peace out, guys.